Hello and welcome to the second part of the liquid penetration testing. So students, in the previous lecture of liquid penetration testing, our studies on the definition on LPT, its working principle and its procedure. Then we can start the penetration testing material. In the previous lecture, can only complete the penetrant portion. From this lecture session, we will continue the other parts of the penetrant testing material. So students, let's start the today's class session. Start with the cleaner and emulsifier. A cleaning fluid must act as a solvent. That is to be for the material that is to be removed. For water-based penetrants, a simple water wash or rinse is suitable for the cleaning step. For petroleum-based penetrants, there are two alternate methods for cleaning the test piece. The most direct approach is to use an oil or chlorine-based solvent. Another method is to use an emulsifier that reacts with the oil-based penetrant to form a water solution soluble substance, which then may be removed by water washing or rinsing. So students, cleaner and emulsifier, in case of cleaner and emulsifier, a removal cleaning fluid must act as the solvent. So for water-based penetrant, a simple water wash or rinse is suitable for cleaning. For petroleum based penetrant, oil or chlorine based solvent is used, and for oil based penetration, emulsifier is used. There are two types of emulsifier. One is hydrophilic and another is lipophilic are available. Hydrophilic emulsifiers are composed of material similar to common detergent, which react with the oil-based penetrant in a way that removes the penetrant from the surface. Diffusion plays a minor role in the action of the hydrophilic emulsifier. So, hydrophilic emulsifier is a water-based solution. Surfactant or mixture of chemical. It works based on the principle of peeling the penetrant. It needs pre-rising prior to emulsifier application to help remove 60 to 80% penetrant and provide an even surface applied by the immersion of spray. Next is lipophilic emulsifier. Lipophilic emulsifier, on the other hand, the oil soluble and they diffuse into the penetrant, breaking down the structure so that the penetrant may be rinsed away with water. There are a number of methods used in a cleaning process, such as wiping with a cloth, dipping in a tank, rinsing with a hose, or some combination of these. The choice of the cleaning process again depends on the many variables of the test notably size, shape, and material of the compound, as well as the test environment. For in situ urban plant components application, cleaning with our cloth and solvent is most convenient. One of the most effective cleaning method is the use of trichloroethylene vapor. So Suraj, the lipophilic emulsifier is an oil based solution. It is a diffusion mechanism follow. Both molecules of emulsifier and penetrant penetrate each other to form a washable mixture. Rate of diffusion increases as concentration and temperature raised. So there are basically two types of emulsifier. One is hydrophilic, another is lipophilic. The choice of the cleaning process again, depends on the many variables of the test, notably size, shape, and material of the component, as well as the test environment. For in situ or in plant components application, cleaning with the cloth and solvent is most convenient. One of the most effective cleaning method is the use of trichloroethylene vapor. So after the cleaner and emulsifier, next is the developer. The developer material is used to enhance the conspicuity of the indication. For fluorescent penetrant, the developer background should appear black when illuminated by the ultraviolet light. The penetrant material concentrated around the defect will appear bright and appear distinct from the black background of the developer. The developer for visible dye penetrant normally creates a white background and contrasts the normal red appearance of the dye pulled out of the crack or pore. The developer material may be one of the several types, like dry powder, aqueous or wet powder suspension, solvent, suspendable, plastic film, and water soluble. Application of the developer may be accomplished by several techniques, such as spray, immerse, passing the part through a developer, dust, cloud, chamber, fluidized bed, and electrostatic means. The solvent suspensible developer may be used along with both the visible light and fluorescent penetrants, and is most suitable for in situ application on plant component. Aqueous or wet powder suspension type developer are applied typically by immersion or spray immediately after the washing step and before the part is dry. Dry powder developer is applied directly to the part immediately after the penetrant removal process. The highest sensitivity is obtained with solvent spray, plastic film spray, and water soluble spray. The least sensitivity is obtained by the dry immersion and dust cloud methods. So students, developers are used to enhance the conspicuity of the indication. For the fluorescent penetrant black background developer illuminated by ultraviolet light, and for visible penetration the white background developer contrasts the normal red dye. Application of the developer may be accomplished by spray immersion, passing the part through a dust cloud chamber, fluidized bed, and electrostatic mix. Now comes to the property of a good developer. So good developer properties are, it's a good absorber, it has a good absorption characteristics, it has to be a good contrast background, it is able to uniformly cover the surface with a thin smooth coating, it provide a good contrast background for bright and clean indication, it has to be non-toxic, it is easy to remove after the inspection. So students, these 6 points are more important for a good developer, to be a good developer: a good absorption characteristic, good contrast background, ability to uniform cover the surface to provide a good contrast background for bright and clean, non-toxic, has to be non-toxic, easy to remove after the inspection. There are different types of developer. One is dry powder developer, aqueous or wet powder suspension developer, solvent suspendable developer, plastic film developer, and water soluble developer. The application of the developer may be accomplished by several techniques such as spray, immersion, passing the part through a developer dust cloud chamber, fluidized bed, and electrostatic mix. The solvent suspensible developer may be used along with the both the visible light and fluorescent penetration, and is the most suitable for in situ application on plant components. Aqueous and wet powder suspension tank developer are applied typically by immersion or spray immediately after the washing step and before the part is dry. Dry powder developer is applied directly to the part immediately after the penetrant removal process. The higher sensitivity is obtained with solvent spray, plastic film spray, and water soluble spray. The least sensitivity is obtained by the dry immersion and dust cloud methods. So after the developer, next is special requirement. When using various chemical or water penetrant material or on austenitic stainless steel, titanium, nickel base, or other high temperature alloy, it is not needed to restrict the impurity such as sulfur, halogen, and alkyl material, since these impurities may cause embrittlement or corrosion, particularly at elevated temperature. Current standard indicates the impurity level of sulfur and halogen exceeding 1% of any one suspect element may be considered excessive. However, even this level may be considered unacceptable in some case. So the actual maximum acceptable impurity level must be decided by the user or designer. For example, halogens are required to be restricted to 25 ppm parts per million in all the chemical used for the testing authentic stainless steel by the dry penetration method. So students, special requirement, it needed to restrict the impurity such as sulfur, hydrogen, halogen and alkyl materials during the use of various chemical or water penetration material on authentic stainless steel, titanium, nickel based or high temperature alloy. The impurity level of sulfur and halogen exceeding 0.1% of many of the suspect element may be considered as excessive. The next is test block. Aluminium and steel blocks are used in quality control of penetrant testing material. The test blocks are prepared to rigid specification as stated in the code. Aluminium block test block of the dimension are 75 mm into 100 mm into 8 mm. These test blocks are prepared by heating the center and water quenched so as to produce thermal shocks. Heating at the center of the block at 773 Kelvin and then quenching is cold water produce crack on the surface. Steel block are also used to test block and are prepared from AISI type 301 or 302 stainless steel. The blocks are used for checking the quality of penetrants, emulsifier and developer. Among them, the most important quality is the sensitivity of the penetrant and is described viscosity. Applicable code may be referred to. For checking the sensitivity, the suspected or faulty penetrant is applied on 1/2 of the surface of the test block and the standard penetrant is applied to the remaining half of the surface. Operational procedure to be followed is as per the recommended production of the manufacturer. If the sensitivity of the tested penetrant is less than that of standard penetrant, the penetrant being tested is considerably inadequate in variety and discard. So students, in the test blocks, basically we are used aluminium and steel blocks. Test blocks are prepared to rigid the specification. 75 mm into 100 mm into 8 mm is the dimension of the
ideal aluminium block, a steel block which is prepared from AISI type in year of IS 2. After the test block, next is penetrant testing methods. There are three types of methods. Water washable method, post emulsifiable method, and third one is solvent removal method. So students, today we'll discuss already discuss on that penetrant testing materials, and from the next class we'll discuss on these penetrant testing methods. So till then stay safe and stay home and stay safe. Okay, thank you so much, class.